We'll discuss into the solar water heating systems. This solar water heating systems you might have seen on rooftops, 100 liters. They are available in multiples of 100 liters, like 100 liter, 200 liters, 300 liters. Modular, you can add on whatever you want, but minimum size is 100 liters. They consist of a flat plate or a evacuated tube solar collector, a storage tank, and connecting pipes. So basically there are two types of system. One is the earlier one, that is flat plate collector with copper tubes, and now second is the evacuated tube collector, which is made of glass tubes. Then there is a storage tank, insulated storage tank, which will store the hot water, and connecting pipelines. So these systems are generally installed on the rooftop or on the open ground with the collector facing the sun, and they are connected to continuous water supply. So you have seen on the top of the solar collector, na, on the altitude beyond that, you will have a small water tank which will feed the water to the solar collector. So the in the southern hemisphere, these are always facing towards the north facing roof. If you are having a roof north facing and south facing, so this is placed on the north facing roof. But in India, we are putting it on the south facing. It will be always facing south and inclined to around 30 degrees angle. The water stored in the tank remains hot overnight, as the storage tank is insulated and the heat losses are small. So you can see the sunlight is falling on the flat plate collector. Cold water is supplied continuously. This is wrong actually. It is not supplied. This is for a house, it is not there. For a big installations, there can be a pump, but for small house installation, there will not be a pump. The pump will supply the water to overhead tank, and from the overhead tank, due to gravity, it will flow to the flat plate collector, and after getting heated, it will come to the storage tank. This vertical tank, what is shown here. So the solar water flat plate collector, they can reach a. You can get water of 40 to 60 degrees centigrade. Okay, so it depends highly on the ambient temperature. It has good efficiency if the ambient temperature, means the atmospheric air temperature, is high. And in summer months, it is better, and than the winter months, because winter the temperature will fall down. So the flat plate collector usually consists of copper tubes which are welded to the sheets, and they are both coated with highly absorbing black coating and with a toughened glass rooftop for cover and insulating material at the bottom. The entire assembly is placed in the box. You can see here, there is a box here. Okay, sunlight is falling there. On the top there is a glass, toughened glass, and this you can see the absorber tubes are there, cross section of the tubes are there, and below that there is a plate, and it is covered by insulation and placed in a box. So solar light will heat will come, that are short waves, that few length, they come hit, then they get reflected. But because the glass has got a property that it will allow the short waves to come, but it will not allow the long wavelength reflected radiation to go back. So the heat is absorbed by the tubes and the plate, because they are not only made of copper, but they are also coated black, and hence the liquid which is flowing inside, mostly water, that gets heated up. These are old type, but now the latest type is the evacuated tube collector. You can see the picture here. So you have got a drum, and this drum is connected to the, these are the glass tubes. Okay, and these glass tubes are also painted, coated basically, not painted. And these produce better efficiency. So here the temperature also is more. For higher temperatures, evacuated tube collectors are used. Now it is common. Now you don't find that flat plate collectors. In market, you will only get these. It is evacuated tube collectors. Evacuated tube collector is less dependent on the ambient temperature, unlike flat plate collector, and its efficiency does not drop with the ambient temperature. They are good not only in summer but also in winter when the ambient temperature falls down. In this type of solar collector, evacuated tubes are used instead of copper tubes, And in this case, there is a top glass cover is not required, and also the insulation box is also not required. Okay, water flows through the tubes, absorbs solar heat, and is stored in the tank. So this movement of water is through gravity and thermosiphon effect only. There is no pump here. The water comes from the tank into the tubes and goes back into the tank. Only thing, due to the density difference in the tank, the hot water will be in the top and cold water will be bottom, and you will be taking out the hot water from the top. So they can reach high temperatures around, you can see even water boiling at 100 degrees centigrade in this ETC. The ETC consists of two concentric glass tubes as shown in the picture here. The air is evacuated between the gaps of the tubes. The evacuated double wall glass tubes provide thermal insulation similar to that of a thermos bottle. The outer glass tube is clear, it is a plain glass, outer glass, and the surface of the inner glass tube is coated with a special heat material that absorbs the sun's energy. So you can see here, the cross section, if you just see the cross section, you'll have a better idea. There are two tubes here, concentric tubes here. Okay, this is a cut section. And inside, in the center, there is a feed tube. Okay, and outside and the annulus, you have got two tubes. The outermost tube is a plain glass tube. Okay, and the inside tube, concentric tube, is again a glass tube, but it has got a selective coating. Because of this selective coating, heat is trapped, one thing. But in between these two glass tubes, the air is removed and there is vacuum. This exactly acts like a thermos flask. I think in thermos flask you have seen, if you keep hot water, fill the thermos flask, close the lid tightly, then it will remain hot for hours together. Same is the case here, because the there is no heat loss due to convection, conduction or radiation. So you can see here, there is an evacuated space between the two tubes, and the inner tube is coated with a selective coating, and water enters. There is one more tube in the center. Water enters in the inlet tube and goes through the outlet tube. So this is the ETC, or evacuated tube collector, which is commonly used today. Thank you.